got the Olight M2R Warrior for review today. Go ahead and get this out of the way here. The box that it comes in, fairly nice looking box. It's got all the features and specs here on the back, as you can see, listed at 1500 lumens, bumping down to 700, or in the second mode, which will be explained in my rather lengthy write-up, it's listed as 1000 lumens, 700 on high, 250 on the medium one, 60 on medium 2, 15 on low, 1 lumen on moonlight. And there's your run time, 3 minutes step down from turbo, 120 minutes after that, 2 hours if you start high, 6 hours 15 minutes on medium, 20 hours on medium or on high, let's see, high, medium 1, 6 hours and 15 minutes, medium 2, 20 hours, low 70 hours, and moon 25 days. But like I say, everything comes in this box, which is all well done. This is instructions that tell you a little bit about the tactical tail switch and the usage of it and all that. This stuff isn't packed just like I got it, because I never can get all the stuff exactly like it was. But you get the instruction manual that comes with it, user manual, whatever you want to call it, and then the lights down here in this padded case. This was the battery insulator, shipping insulator. And then in here, this part of the box, there's a Olight, if I can get it out of there, advertisement or whatever you want to call this that comes in there. It's got some of their different lights and stuff listed on there in case you want to look at that. And then this part of it contains your holster, which this is a really nice nylon holster. It's got the snap enclosure here instead of the usual Velcro snaps down. It's got where you can put it on your belt here, or if you prefer, trying to see this from behind the camera here, figure out which end's what, that unsnaps. That's solid sewn on for your belt, but that unsnaps if you wanted to snap it on something. And then if you had a carabiner or want to hook it on your backpack or whatever, it's got that eye there that you can hook it on something. And then inside the holster is your lanyard and your charging cord, which the charging cord just goes right on there like so. All it's needed to charge the light, or you can do it on a traditional charger. You can unscrew the tail cap and take the battery out, you know, put it on your charger just like usual. And the orientation with these Olight tail charging lights, the positive end actually goes up in these lights. It's pretty much, well, it is the opposite of most any light you're used to, probably, unless you have some of these tail charging Olights. So now that that's all out of the way, this is a side switch and tail switch flashlight. I don't know if you can see that little dot right there inside the switch button. That's a red low voltage indicator light that will come on when the cell is around 3.1 or 3.2 volts to let you know the cell is getting low. The tail switch is bead blasted stainless. It almost looks anodized or painted, but it's just bead blasted stainless. It's got the bi-directional clip. You can hook that on your ball cap and use it as a headlamp, or you can carry it in your pocket this way. Also, the clip will move to here. So, I mean, it's actually a four-way clip, I guess you could say, because you can carry it either way on either end. And then this tail switch, this is a tactical switch, which by that, a half press and you get full turbo. And if you press all the way down, you get strobe. That's it in this mode group. That's all you get. And there is another mode group. You press that tail switch all the way down and then click the side switch. That puts it into the other mode group, which is a half press turbo. Might be blinding everybody, but it's a half press turbo momentary, or you can push it all the way and turbo stays on. Then your side switch is a long press and it comes on in moonlight. Yes, that's actually on. It's just a really, really dim moonlight. You barely can see it with light on here. And then from there, it's about a half a second press between each mode to go up, or you can simply hold that side button down, scroll through the modes, and stop in whatever mode you want. If you double click the side switch, you go to turbo, and if you click it three times real quick, you get your strobe. And that's all the side switch functions there. Now if the light's on, instead of, you know, if you have your hand back here and can't re-grasp the light or something, you can bump that tail switch and turn the light off, which I thought was pretty neat. And then if you press and hold this tail switch, your light is then locked out. Nothing happens. So it's electronic lockout. Nothing happens either way. And then to unlock it, you simply press and hold again. It's back on in moonlight, ready to go. And as I say, that will turn it off, simply pressing that. And then your mode group change, I think I already showed that. I'm not even sure now. But that's a half press momentary in that mode group. And then a full press on puts it to a constant output or constant on. That's constant on, and then a half press. And then to change it back, you fully depress, click the side switch, and then you're back to a half press turbo or full press strobe. So if you grab this light at night, have it in this mode here, you know, you can either blind somebody with steady light, or you can press it all the way and strobe them to death, either way. I like the bezel on this. It's different, it's unique, it's blue. I just love it. It's got the cooling fans right here. And then it's got, instead of the traditional knurling, it's got this ribbing in it with the lateral lines. It's got the laterals on the tail cap to match, and the laterals on the head to match those. And then it's also got your diagram here for your strobe or your momentary turbo. I don't know what else to go over. Like I say, I've got a real lengthy review. These threads, let me get quiet here. That's the first noise I've heard out of that. It's just really quiet though. Whenever you're screwing that tail cap, it's really smooth threads on it. And I hadn't even checked to see Yeah, it's got a manual lockout. Takes about an eighth of a turn there, and it's locked out. It's got a XHP 35 down in there. It is a neutral white, which tickles me. I'm a neutral white lover. And it's got a constant current driver in it. And other than that, I think I'm gonna get on with the rest of the review. I've got a lot of still photos of this light. I've got beam shots outside at different yardage. I compared this with the Olight M2R 2500 lumen headlamp, and also the Manker quad emitter 2500 light. So I got those compared in the live footage and everything, and then there'll be the lengthy write-up, like I say. But that is the Olight M2R Warrior, and we will get on to the rest of the review, and I will see y'all shortly.
Didn't take no chances. Who was a
Okay, starting out on the moon mode, 18, 20 inches in front of the camera there with my hand. And we'll go up to the low mode, probably about 5 yards or so in front of the camera there. The medium one, I guess is what that would be. And that's probably about 10 to 12 yards. That's the next medium. That tree out there tonight is 60 yards away. Going up to the high mode at 60 yards. And then I went blank. The turbo mode. Again at 60 yards. Keep in mind this is a 1500 lumen rated light. And I've got the Manker E14-2 out here, which is a 2500 lumen rated light. And that's with it on turbo. And there's the Olight MR2 on turbo. This Manker is a quad emitter. And this one is a single XHP35 orange field reflector. Done been over all that. That's the Olight. And that's the Manker. So as far as on target, the Manker's putting a lot more light on target. Not quite as broad a beam, but it does put a lot of light down there. Get this Manker turned off here. And the other light that I brought out here for comparison is the Olight H2R. They're a big powerful headlamp. We'll get it on turbo, and of course at 2500 lumens and a big floody beam, that thing just lights up everything. You can see a lot with it. But again, there is the M2R. And there's the Olight H2R. Again, more light on target with the M2R. Much more floody beam, although another 1,000 lumens. It's more close-up light. This isn't a real super throwy light, this M2R. But you can see some distance with it, just sheer output, really. I mean, those trees right there, right in there, are probably 120 yards or so, just guessing at it. So, you know, like I say, you can see a little bit of distance with it. And then the barn down there, we're just almost exactly 100 yards from it right now. Shift down a little bit here. Oop, I missed it. That's high mode, about 100 yards with the M2R. So even in high mode, you cover some distance out there. Again, turbo. And it lights up a pretty good area. I know upside that headlamp, it don't look like that big an area, but those trees right down there, the one by the barn and that next one over there, one by the barn is probably 45 foot tall. And that next one's probably 50 foot or so. You can see from 100 yards that more than lights those up without a problem. So that is the M2R with the XHP 35. I went off camera there a second. There was some farm implements I was going to shine on. Just see how I picked them up. But that mineral lick over there, for any of those that know what a mineral lick is, it's for the cattle. That thing's probably about 50 to 55 yards. And it shows up perfect. But I'm going to go ahead and wrap this video up for tonight. I do appreciate everybody watching, and I will be seeing y'all next time.